Dead arms, dead legs, dead feet. Death is everywhere. What is going on? Hey everyone, Laci Green here for D News. You wake up in the morning sleeping on your arm, and as you go to move, nothing. Complete deadness. A dead arm can be a really strange experience, like you no longer have any control over it. I can pick it up with my other hand and wave it around, which feels tingly and brings back some of the sensation slowly. But sometimes there's even this brief prickly burning that actually hurts. I distinctly remember the first time this happened to me when I was maybe 10 or 11, and for a moment I thought something was seriously wrong with me. Like, oh my God, my hand is never gonna move again. But here I am, still alive with hands intact. Turns out dead arms, feet, legs, and other limbs are a very common occurrence, and it's pretty interesting why it happens. See, in order to have control of your limbs, your brain needs to be able to communicate through your nerve pathways to say, move, arm, walk, leg. Those nerve pathways also carry sensation information back to your brain that tells you how something feels or that it's moving. But when any sort of pressure is applied to a part of your body for a while, it squeezes those nerve pathways, and the electrochemical impulses can't transmit and tell the body part what to do. It's a common misunderstanding that you get a dead limb because blood flow stops, but if that were true, you could say bye-bye to your hand, and crisscross applesauce would be a deadly undertaking. What actually happens with the pressure on the arteries is that it cuts off the nutrient supply to your nerve cells, making them get all weird. The cells might stop transmitting information, they might start freaking out and sending impulses all over the place. Those erratic impulses are actually why it feels like pins and needles, the official name of which is paresthesia. This is what happens when you hit your funny bone or the ulnar nerve running along your elbow as well. It's cell freakout from the pressure. As you shake out your dead limb, the nerves slowly reestablish themselves, and it can take a sec for the impulses to go back to normal, or sometimes more than a sec. I've had it last a few minutes before. Having your nerves misfire while there's some pressure on them isn't a huge deal unless it goes on for a long time. It's actually pretty handy that a lot of the time a limb will start to tingle first. It's your body trying to alert you before you do some serious damage. With prolonged pressure, the nerves could stop transmitting feelings altogether. So there you have it. Now go swing at your friend's funny bone and give them a science lesson. Or don't, actually. That's kind of evil. Thanks for watching D News, folks. Be sure to subscribe for more science updates.